Thank you, 617. 401k and IRA accounts, of course, can be confusing. And we are pleased to have Stephanie Parker, an IRA administrator at Delta Trust and Bank this morning, joining us now to break it all down and explain this to us. Stephanie, good morning to you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
First of all, define the difference between, we got the 401k and the IRA. Let us know the difference between the two.
Well, a 401k is a benefit offered. It's sponsored by your employer. It is mostly funded by contributions or deferrals that come directly out of your paycheck, where an IRA is an individual investment option that is funded solely with your funds or rollovers from a 401k.
Okay, and there's got to be some benefits for the IRA. Let us know what those are.
There are a lot of benefits to an IRA. one of the main ones being is you have a wider range of investment options. You have things other than stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and the regular market. With an IRA, you can invest in real estate, you can invest in privately held stocks, partnerships. Of course, there are strict IRS guidelines that you will have to follow to make sure that you are not doing something that is prohibited.
Okay, so if you have the IRA, then how does one go about even investing in real estate with that?
It is very simple. You have to purchase the real estate with the funds inside the IRA. The real estate is titled in the name of the IRA under your custodian's tax ID number. This is my specialty at Delta Trust. We have a lot of information that we can give to people if they're interested in it. But ultimately, the best place to start is with your CPA or tax advisor.
Okay, are there different types of real estate that someone can invest in with the IRA?
There are. You can invest in timberland. You can invest in farmland, rental property, businesses. And again, I want to stress, you need to consult with a professional, a CPA tax advisor before doing this.
Okay, so if an IRA account is established for retirement purposes, if that's the object here, then what happens to the property then when one person retires?
The majority of people will sell the property and put the cash will go into the IRA to be available for them when they need it.
Okay, and people can contact you at Delta Trust
yes,
Bank
they
if
can.
They have any questions.
Yes, they can.
What is the best way to go about that? Give you a call?
Give me a call. I'm there Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 every day. I have an email. I can be reached by that.
A lot of people, I bet, call with confusing questions. It can be confusing, so to be able to break it down in a simple way.
It is very confusing, and I'm always happy to go more in depth with anybody about this because it really is not as scary as it seems.
Which is good.
Yes.
All right, Stephanie Parker with Delta Trust and Bank, thank you so much for coming on this morning and waking up with us. We greatly appreciate it. We're going to take a quick break here on this Friday morning. Still ahead, we will have a look at today's brighter side of news. Find out how a group of fourth graders from Theodore Jones Elementary in Conway celebrated Earth Day this week. Keep it here. Your local forecast coming up next. It is 620.
Today's THV This Morning is sponsored by Everett Buick GMC, by Pfizer Kubota Twin City Tractor and Equipment, and by